I was massively fortunate for Asus to send me the ROG Strix B850-I gaming Wi-Fi before its launch at CES 2025. Okay, so this video is going to be a comprehensive overview that I like to call a spotlight as opposed to a normal review, because this is a pre-launch model, so the actual performance test may change as well as the price. So let me tell you what we are going to be talking about today. Why is this launch important? What's in the box? The overall design, connectivity, inputs and outputs, and software and features. B launches are generally significant because when new silicone launches, it's always the higher end boards or X boards that are first released. However, when the B650 was launched, it was launched only a month after the X670, but in this case on the B850, it's taken 3 months for that launch, making people that wanted a more affordable board have to wait a little bit longer. Summarize, B series launches marks a time of affordability as B platforms are generally cheaper than X series, which gives opportunity to those who have been waiting to hop onto the new platform. Onto what's in the box. First and most importantly, the motherboard, the B850i, and you will get a panel cable as well as USB 2 splitters. You will also get two SATA 6 gigabit per second cables, Q antenna, cable ties, an extra M.2 Q latch, a M.2 Q slide, a ROG keychain, a M.2 rubber, which is important for SSDs that only have silicone on one side, screws for the M.2, and a quick start guide. The design is a typical ITX design and very similar to what we saw in the B650EI. Note that the E means topmost or the best of a series. We do, however, see some slight movements of silicone and some aesthetic design changes. Design-wise, the specifications are: it's ITX in form factor, 17 centimeters by 17 centimeters, weighing in at 810 grams. The chipset is a B850. Power to the CPU is a 8-pin connector located on the top left. The socket set is AM5-1718 pin grid array. There are two PCIe 5 NVMe slots. In the front, you have the ability to put in a 2242, 60 or 80 using either the Q slide or Q latch. And the back, you can put in a 2280 or 2260. Two SATA 6 gigabit per second ports. Two DDR5 dual channel DIMMs supporting up to 96 gigabytes with overclock support. Now, this overclock support supports up to 8,000 on 7,000 series, 8,400 on 8,000 series, and 8,200 on 9,000 series. One PCIe 5 X16 expansion slot for your graphics card. A chunky VRM heatsink with fan, perfect for the new 9000 series. Power phasing of 10 plus 2 plus 1 with Pro Cool power connectors. And you will also find flex key, BIOS flashback, and CMOS clear buttons. For connectivity and input outputs, the front panel can accommodate one USB 2 3.2 Gen 2 connector, one USB 3.2 Gen 1 header, and one USB 2.0 header. On the back panel, you will find one USB 3.2 Gen 2 X2 USB-C at 20 gigabits per second, one Gen 3.2 USB-C at 10 gigabits per second with DP alt mode at 1.4A, four USB Gen 3.2 A's at 10 gigabits per second, two USB Gen 2 type A's, one HDMI 2.1, three TRS jacks, which is your line in, line out, and mic in, one optical SPDIF out. A note on sound, it incorporates ROG Supreme FX 7.1 with codecs ALC 4080, one 2.5 gigabit Ethernet LAN port, one 2x2 Wi-Fi 7 module with aerial connectors supporting 2.5, 5, and 6. Onto software and features, and a notable mention before we go into the details of software is this board is Asus AI ready. The first thing that I want to cover is Armory Crate, which has improved significantly with features like the dashboard having quick access to frequency monitoring, temperature monitoring, general use, fan monitoring, and voltage. Quick CPU overclock, fan speed, scenario profiles, power saving and monitoring, game launcher, and Aura Sync. Next is device management, and for the motherboard itself, you can access the addressable headers, go into disk info, and importantly, Asus Wi-Fi Q antenna, which allows you to have fast check, direction finder, and traffic monitor, making sure that your setup is perfect for Wi-Fi access. Next is Game First, which has also come a long way because you have the ability to overview with adaptive intelligence. There's a network monitor, system analyzer that shows you system history as well as Wi-Fi quick assist, network doctor, which is app statistics, and settings, which has game turbo. Another important one is Fan Expert 4, which has amazing analysis and auto tuning and gives you curves for cooling optimization. Next, we have Aura Sync for all your RGB needs, Game Library for accessing your games through Armory Crate, Scenario Profiles, and Tools. In Tools, you will find the ability to update your drivers, your utilities, you'll also find manuals and documents, and individual kits. And lastly, Settings, where we have the update settings, but also importantly, there is a new app, which is a browser-enacted one that shows you all the details of your build and allows you to update all of your firmware and drivers. So a lot to look forward to, and really impressive addition of Q Antenna, which gets the best performance out of your Wi-Fi through its optimization in the app. As it stands, the release market suggested retail price will be 7599, that is Rand, which puts it at a similar price to the B650-EI, but with the improvements on features and specification. And that's it. If you have any questions, more details will follow on launch, but I'm happy to answer any questions you may have in the comment section below. Look forward to seeing you on the next video. Cheers, goodbye.